Hello and welcome to Maca Blue's free initiative for UPSC aspirants preparing for anthropology optionals. As it is a COVID crisis situation, it's very difficult for the students to attend the classes that is conducted in offline, and also students find that online classes are highly priced. So Maca Blue has thought to make an initiative by which students can make sure that their preparation for UPSC anthropology optional is going hassle-free without any economic burden on them. We hope that this will help all the students to understand the subject in a more depth, and also according to the current trend that can be expected in 2021 examination with respect to the COVID. So once again, we welcome you all. So welcome to this first session. This session we will cover only about the syllabus, and the syllabus, I just want to emphasize, not the entire syllabus. I just want to make sure that you are understanding what exactly will anthropology as a discipline in UPSC optional will experience, or what is expected from you post COVID. So whatever you have prepared before that, you can keep that as a one jotted point all over in your mind, but that is not enough as of now. So post-COVID anthropology strategy to score. We all know that we have chosen our anthropology optional with one prior intention, that is one thing, the subject is almost static in nature. We will come to the part of static once again. The second thing is that this is highly scoring subject. So this is a most sought optional subject in the UPSC field. Now, if you are a candidate or aspirant who have already given two or three attempts in anthropology as optional, then don't think that your preparation is all done. You can wrap up the portions and just concentrate on your GS papers. Like every disciplines, like every optional subject and GS paper has seen the tremendous change, and the trends is changing with the COVID pandemic. The same thing is applicable to anthropology also. You can see that whatever thing that you have studied still needs some kind of extra polish. It needs some kind of extra add-on points, because in the contemporary world, anthropology is becoming one of the most sought-after subject with wide range of researchers that is having its scope expanded everywhere. So like your GS paper, like polity and everything, you add the current points, it is also relevant in anthropology now to make sure that your answer is in a way that is unique. Second thing, your answer should reflect the psychology of yourself as a future bureaucrat. It should show your clear vision to the subject, to the happenings around the world, your ability to interconnect every points that is happening all around the globe, at least in the optional subject you have taken. So this is what the examiner will expect. The portions that you have studied earlier, I don't say that the pre-lectures are not of any use. They are of use, but only for the static portion. So here we will differentiate what exactly is the static portion, and what are the topics in which the COVID pandemic has affected, and in which you need some kind of additional revisions and add-ons. So now we will move to the So what is the latest trend in the examination? We will analyze this with paper 1 and paper 2 syllabus. As you all know that anthropology is having paper 1 and paper 2 syllabus, okay? Each paper is for 250 marks. Now don't ask me about the books that is important. We will cover that in another session, or I will try to make that as a write-up for you also. But as of now, I'll say that don't go for any books. Don't go for any books. Don't ask me that whether Braintree is enough, whether going for some other coaching materials is sufficient. It is sufficient for only your static understanding. You need to get to the discipline in the more contemporary way. If you have to crack the 2021 or beyond that, whatever year you're writing the examination, you have to change the way in which you have studied. The traditional method is needed. But apart from your conventional studies, you need to add some more things. You need to pull up your socks more. But still, it doesn't reduce the chance of scoring high in the subject. If you're writing some, at least some kind of points with the new aspects, I'm sure that your paper is going to impress the examiner and you are getting more marks on that also. So let's go to the syllabus. First, we are covering the paper 1 syllabus. So what is there in paper 1? The first 1.1, meaning and scope and development of anthropology. See, this is one of the topic that is mostly ignored by the student, but this is one of the very important topic. And post-COVID trend in anthropology syllabus, if you ask me what is the changes that is happening, the first change that is going to happen is in this part of the syllabus itself. If you have already prepared this topic, you have to take the topic again. You have to add on the most of the important things that you would have missed out or you would have failed to see it. If you are a student who is starting the preparation, don't start anything. We will just gradually focus and cover everything by covering the major things, by including the most contemporary things that is relevant for your examinations to make your answers unique from that of the others. Okay. So the scope and development. The scope has widened. With the time of COVID, the scope of anthropology in every aspect have widened. So there you have to include this kind of pandemic effect on the discipline also need to be incorporated to make sure that your scope, that your writing is contemporary in nature. Now with respect to the second topic, that is 1.2, relationship with other disciplines, history, economics, sociology, psychology, political science, life science, medical science. Yeah, let me tell you, the medical science the relationship with anthropology, this is very, very, very important as of now. Why is it so? Because there are so much of studies on the anthropological understanding of medicine that is happening. So many research papers has been presented as of now. So the questions can come from the most ignored section in 2021 examination onwards. So be careful about that. Don't just revise it from any previous topper's notes or any material that is available to you. You have to just spend some more time to make sure that you're having the most clear points in your hand. Then with the discipline of economics and its connection with anthropology, because in future the purchase, the consumer behavior, everything, this need to be a clear understanding. The economist will present the understanding, but that will happen with the help of anthropologists because they know the correct pulse of the people. And psychology, you know, one of the most important thing that is hot debated is the psychology of people that is changing in the time of pandemic. It is very much important. You cannot ignore the topic of the relevance of anthropology and the psychology. The connection between both of them is very, very, very important as of now. Then life science also, then epidemiology. In that also, anthropological connection is very much important. Now the third one is 1.3. If 1.1 and 1.2 is having the changes, then obviously 1.3 is also having changes. So you can see in the paper 1 itself, the first three topics that you would have studied previously with only the conventional writings that is available, even that needs a lot of revision when it comes to the 2021 onwards examination, because you are not writing in any ordinary examination. Remember, you are writing the UPSC examination, the country's most sorted, most toughest examination. But that needs a wise mind, that needs a very great vision to go for it. Because you are not gonna be a normal person when you come out of the examination. When you crack it, you are the bureaucrats. You are the one who is making the rules. You are the one to administer the common masses. So you must have that much of knowledge. You need that much of knowledge. That is why it demands a vast study, vast knowledge, vast vision is demanded in UPSC field. So what is the changes in 1.3? When it comes to the socio-cultural anthropology, let me tell you. The culture of human beings has been changing from time to time, is it so? Now the culture change due to the COVID is very relevant, because for example, if you take one of the most important topics in socio-culturalists, the religion, magic, those kind of topics. Okay, so if you take the religion also, you can see that the burial practices that happened previously is not the same. The institutions is changing. The sacred geography is changing nowadays. So So everything, the culture, the values of the culture that was given before is starting to change now. So those needs to be incorporated also. Then biological anthropology. When with respect to the study of biological anthropology, the anthropological impact on different genders with respect to the COVID and the genetic connections of the COVID, all these things are also studied. When you not just COVID, before COVID, if you take the SARS-CoV or MERS-CoV also, you can find the genetic connection with those studies of the virus also. Then this is 1.1, 1.2, 1.3 is having these kind of changes. Now let's move. Now 1.2, these topics are not having any kind of changes. This, if you have already covered this topic, then forget it. You don't have to spend any time in this. Just have to practice sufficient questions. Here there is no kind of questions or no kind of changes that is gonna happen in the syllabus. Just you have to remember some of the fossils or recent discoveries that has appeared in the news. If you have been a regular newspaper reader, then you have got lucky with that. But still, if you haven't done, no issues, because as much as you can mug up from whatever the lectures that we gonna cover is just enough. You need not to cover beyond that, because you are not gonna write a PhD also. You have to keep it as a balancing. You need not to go to the deepest roots, but you need not to stand in the brim of the subject also. You have to have some connectivity to it in a way that you are able to present a vision of the subject, not you are gonna mug up those all the portions. Okay, now we will move to the next one. Next one is the evolutionary trend and everything. Here also there is no kind of changes that is expected. 1.5 also no changes with respect to COVID crisis. 2.1 is a very interesting topic for all the students. If it is sociology also, if it is anthropology also, this is one of the most interesting topic. Here, the impact of urbanization, these kind of topics is having more relevance. Not only in anthropology, it is also having important and relevance in your GS papers and also in your essay papers. We will discuss very deeply about the feminist movements in anthropology. It is also very, very expected questions for 2021, 22 year, etc. Then here there is no much of changes that is expected in 2.1 from with respect to the COVID crisis. Now let's move to the next one. Concept of kinship. This is very important topic, in fact. But it's enough to study and understand this only from the perspective of your conventional learning if you have covered it. If not, we will cover it. Don't worry. Here also, one more thing. You have to, when you're reading this kinship topic, pay very close attention, because if you're able to relate it with the tribe, etc., and you can find out the relations of the kinship relationship that is existing in different tribe communities. When questions of tribal anthropology comes, here you can crack it more by pointing out the kind of kinship and the marriage patterns that is existing in different societies. Then marriage and the types of marriage, exchanges, all this topic. Here in this, we can see the marriage, the definition of marriage is continuously changing. Earlier, it was just between one male and one woman. There are also definitions of great anthropologists that is relevant for an LGBT community also. So we have to incorporate those kind of things also in the changing relevance of the marriage or the changing nature of marriage. Okay. Anthropology is a subject where you are not supposed to judge. You are not supposed to judge. Remember that when we are saying about the LGBT or the community or the religion, the functionaries or the burial practices or whatever we are discussing, it is just for the heck of your studies. You are not supposed to judge. Okay. 3.1. Study of culture, patterns, process, concept of culture, patterns of culture. Here also there is no much changes that is avoided. And 3.2 and 3.3 is highly scoring topic in your paper.
because from this topic always there is questions. In 1 year there was about 80 marks of questions from this section. So don't ignore the sections. Here the stratification, the social stratification or the social evils like the untouchability, etc., that is also having a new trend nowadays. Haven't you heard about this COVID untouchability? Earlier we had the untouchable related sense only based on the caste, class, creed, etc. Now we are having its more relevance to even if you be a Brahmin also, even if you be the higher upper caste also, even if you be the topmost elite class with the most rich man also, but if you are having the COVID, stay 1,000 steps away from me. Even if you don't have the COVID also, stay far. That is, we are having a different kind of society now. The social pattern, the social communication has already changed. And its impact in rural life is very much important. Those topics will come thereafter. So 3.2 and 3.3 is very important. And this is also having a change with respect to your COVID crisis pandemic. Okay. Then concept of society. The concept of society is changing nowadays. Okay, the how the society, the functions of society, where the society like group of people were living together. Now the group of people living together also there is some kind of alienation between everyone. So the safe distance maintenance. So you can incorporate those things also here. Approaches to the study of culture and society, classical evolution. 3.5 is a very static topic. There is no changes in that. And 4.1, definitions and functions of religion. It is very, very important topic. And also, here you can expect a lot of changes with respect to the contemporary pandemic situation because the religious functions is changing nowadays. The religious customs, the religious rituals that is observed is now changing. The sacred geography is changing. Also, we can see that the ethnomedicine's relevance is falling down. Okay. When COVID have came, there is no relevance for the ethnomedicine. Even the actual medicine that is existing is even not serving the purpose. So, those points and the psychological and functional aspects of religion. For example, we all had the psychological aspect for the religion as a sacred thing. Okay. We thought that the sacred thing can happen only in the sacred geography. We will discuss the sacred geography, a sacred ritual, everything more in detail when we come to these kind of chapters. Don't worry if you are confused with the term sacred geography. It is a very, very important term. Even you can find the questions in previous year question paper like sacred geography. That itself was a question. So that is changing. Earlier our sacred geography, for example, if you are taking the sacred institutions or the religious institutions like temple, monasteries or church or mosque or wherever it is, okay, if you are taking that, that was our sacred geography. Now after the COVID, the sacred geography is coming to your home through your internet media like mobile, laptop, computer, whatever source it is. Your sacred practitioner, like your, in the early days it is shaman, now the priest or imam or the pundit, everyone, or the monasteries people, everyone is now available for you to contact the rituals online. So the way the religious functionaries is changing, how this impact their life, even that is having relevance now. And the burial practices, when it comes to religion, one of the most important thing is birth and death is one of the most important topic when it comes to religion. Okay, the birth practices that was earlier there, you see the baptism is not same anymore. Okay, and the naming ceremonies are not the same anymore. The 40 days ritual, all those things have changed. And moreover, beyond all these things, you can also see that if you take the example of the death rituals, earlier each region people had a kind of their unique identifying death ritual. Now whoever it is, whichever religion it is, no problem. If you have been infected with COVID, then your death ritual is one and the same. So this is also the change that anthropology is viewing. We never expected this kind of changes to emerge in the world. From the science to the religion, from magic to religion to science to religion to again we are getting into the world of science. Okay, the meaning, scope and relevance, principles governing production distribution. Here just only a little bit of changes is needed, like how the economic life is changing with the COVID crisis. But more importantly, you have to fix the topic with respect to the conventional learning only, 5.1. Next one is the 5.2. The 5.2 is not having any kind of changes. Then 6.1, the development anthropology classical, this is very static topic, no changes. The displacement and rehabilitation, this is having some kind of changes with respect to the current developments. Then 7.1 is the very most important topic, and this is having very much changes that has gone through. The first changes in anthropology that is experienced with the COVID pandemic is 7.1. If you take the topic research methodology, can we see a researcher going to the field to study the people or doing the participant observation method? Don't waste your mind with what is this participant observation method, who is the researcher, what is this field work. Don't get worried, we will cover all these things in detail. So that is, the research is not happening in the field. So what is the present method of research that is happening? That is also the changing nature of the research methodology in anthropology during the COVID crisis. It is also very important. Then 8.1, very important, because the gene related topics with respect to the COVID is very much discussed all over. So this is also immunological methods and DNA technology. This is the most important topics that is having the changes with respect to the pandemic. So 8.2, the topics that has the differences, immunological methods, DNA technology and DNA technology, that is it. Here 8.3, no changes. 8.3, no changes. 8.4, no changes. Concept of genetic polymorphism, there is no changes in this also. These are all static. Okay. Now next. Here 8.6 is having very much relevance, because 8.6 relevance because the chromosome and its changes with respect to the gene in the with respect to the response in coronavirus, this is a very important topic. So we have to see the topic with respect to the present pandemic situation also. Then concept of race, you know, America's issues of race. So this topic is having more relevance. Let me ask you one top question, that is, is there any two races nowadays? Is there a true race that is existing? You know, you have the plastic surgery, those kind of options available. If you have a caucasoid eyes, if you have a caucasoid nose, if you are having caucasoid features or a mongoloid features, you can intermix all these things. And with the increase in migration, the race crossing has increased also. You cannot identify who exactly is a Mongolia, who exactly is a Dravidian. You cannot identify one person by one race. One person looks like the combination of many races, in fact. So the concept of race, whether that has its relevance now, think over it. But still, people are fighting for it. They cannot escape its relevance even now, even after so many years. Now 8.8 is not having so much of differences. 8.9 is also not having so much differences now. Impact of smoking air pollutions, this is very important topic, you have to mark it. Then 9.1, the adaptation is not just climatic based. Okay, the biological adaptation is biological adaptation, nutritional adaptation, genetic adaptation with respect to COVID pandemic, with respect to Zika virus, with respect to the other kind of fever, viral, all those things. You have to take that topic to that level and make your studies completed with incorporating those kind of contemporary things. Don't worry, we will cover all these topics one by one. Now let's move to the next. Relevance in understanding the contemporary society, dynamics of ethnicity, rural, urban, etc. Here, the impact of rural life with respect to COVID, this is also very important. Then ethnic boundaries and ethnic conflicts. You know that lot of ethnic boundaries and ethnic conflicts is happening everywhere. So that is also very important. 11.1, no changes. 10.1 also, not really so much changes is expected. Let's move to the next. Here 12.1, no changes with respect to the present. 12.2 also no changes. 12.3 no changes. 12.4 static. 12.5 static still. 12.6 is also static. 12.7 static. 12.8 is also static. 13.1 you have to pick up some relevant examples to relate with the kind anthropometry or the sports of anthropology. Okay. 13.3 is having very much relevance. You know, recently there was a report that is published where we can find that in India, when it comes to the nutrition in India, you can find the standard growth rate is also high. The same time, the standard growth rate is also high. At the very same time, you can find the obesity rate is also very high in teenagers. So this is one relevant topic. Anthropology in designing of defense and other equipments, relevant topic, but no much changes with respect to the COVID crisis or other contemporary issues that is happening. Forensic anthropology, important topic. Then method and principles of genetic identification reconstruction, applied human genetics. These are just as usual topics only. 13.7 is having very much relevance. DNA technology, prevention and cure of diseases. Then 13.8 is having relevance with respect to COVID, that is anthropogenetics in medicine. Then 13.9 is having importance. 13.10 is also, not like 100% changes is needed in that topics, just only the conventional learning is still sufficient. Okay, finally we are done with the paper 1 syllabus. Let's go to the paper 2. If you are getting bored, don't get bored, because it is very much important for you to understand what exactly has changed in your syllabus and what exactly is expected in your syllabus from your examination point of view. Paper 2, the topic 1, very important, but no changes. Topic 2 is important, but no changes. Topic 3 is important, but there is changes with respect to the basis of the inequality. Structural basis of inequality has changed. So you have to compare the structural basis of inequality in traditional Indian society with respect to, you have to compare it with the present structural basis of inequality that is existing in modern world. Emergence, growth and development of anthropology in India. See, anthropology is a discipline that has emerged with the colonial rule. Okay, it is a gift of the colonial rule in India. So we will discuss more about it. Okay, next thing. Five, approaches to study of Indian society, culture, tradition and contemporary. Then aspect of Indian villages, social organizations, these topics. 5.1, 5.2 is not having so much of changes. Okay. Six, point number 6 is having some kind of importance, because you see the topics of migration. Most of the people migrating is tribals. If you see the Toda tribe, their migration. Toda is a tribe in Nilgiris, okay? That is very near to Udagamandalam, that is the present Ooty, very near to Ooty. So, they are one of the pastoral tribe. So, with respect to Toda or those kind of people, those kind of tribes, they are having the migration problems. So now with the COVID, the migration and the migrant problems, all these things you can relate more over here. Also the tribal migration issues, that can be given more importance. And the tribal health during the pandemic situation, their awareness, their education level, all those things also very important. Okay, so chapter 6 is very important. Then point number seven, no much changes is there. With respect to OBC, you can expect some kind of questions. Then constitutional safeguards for scheduled tribes and scheduled castes. Here you can link it with the constitutional provisions also. That apply your knowledge of the GS2 paper here for chapter 7. Then social change and contemporary tribal societies. This is very important. You can see most of the tribes that is in news. Don't miss any of them. It is very, very important. Impact of modern democratic institutions, development programs and welfare missions on tribals and weaker sections. Tribal movements and the quest for identity. Pseudo-tribalism. This is also a very, very important topic. We will discuss the pseudo-tribalism topic in very detail because this is always highly scoring part also. Chapter 8. Colonial rule. This is a static topic. Then 8.1, impact of legions. This is also static. You can add some of the recent studies if you wish. Not relevant also. 8.2, tribe and nation state, comparative study of tribal communities in India and other countries. You know, as I have stated the kinship topic, the marriage topic, I have mentioned that if you are studying this topic very clearly, you can write 2-3 paragraphs for each tribe. When you are asked to write the ethnography of each tribe, you can add their kinship patterns, etc. from there. History of administration of tribal areas. These are all static points. You can understand it very easily, okay? If you are a regular newspaper reader, you may even pick up some of the examples to be incorporated over here. Role of anthropology in tribal and rural development. This topic you have to see from another perspective. Role of anthropology in tribal and rural development in the time of pandemic also. So what is their impact? Contribution of anthropology to the understanding of regionalism, communalism, ethnic and political movements. This is a very static topic. It's enough if you are studying with any study material, that is enough. So that's all. We are almost done with the all the syllabus discussions. Now you might be having the questions like when will we discuss about the books that is relevant. I'm just saying it once again, don't go for books as of now. Let's get acquainted with the topics. Then we will go for it. Now there is some of the toppers book available in the market. If you want, you can buy those books. But I will say that you buy it just as a reference model to understand how to answer the question. Just to understand the answer pattern. Not much need to be focused from those kind of books. So thank you for listening to our lecture. We will come up with the first lecture. I hope you all have understood what is the changes, what that is expected in the anthropology optional in the upcoming 2021-2022 examinations with respect to pandemic, how the pandemic impact your anthropology discipline and how your answer should be culminated in a way that it shows the present contemporary relevance to your answer is added in a way that you impress the examiner to the highest point. So thank you. If you are having any kind of queries, please do make it in the comment box. So we will answer over there. We will start soon with the lectures of each chapters. Most probably, we will start with the society, Indian society topic, because that is always expected for 80 or 80 plus marks. Okay. Thank you all.